Hello everyone, I'm Adriana and today Leonardo is going to work a Xiaomi device with water damages. We can observe that the device neither turns on nor charges. We proceed to pull up the back cover. We apply a little heat and, with the help of a plastic card, we cut the adhesive. We remove the upper antenna and we disconnect the battery connector. We can observe signs of corrosion on the motherboard. I've said it many times that the most important step in the repair of the wet device is the visual inspection. For this reason, you have to pay close attention to the details. Let's check the bottom part of the device. First of all, we observe that the sticker which indicates if the device is wet is intact. I'm going to make you hear a little demo. Let's add a drop of water. Little by little, we observe how the humidity indicator it changes color. Normally, when the device has been in contact with liquids, this sticker turns red. In our case, with this Xiaomi device, we have good news. The lower part was not affected at all. This is the humidity sticker from the upper part, which confirms that the device has been in contact with liquids. In the next minute, we are going to inspect the motherboard. We look for areas with corrosion on the motherboard. The truth is, there is a lot of corrosion, and now the most important thing is to turn on the device and obtain the important voltages on the motherboard. This whole area, we have to clean it. We use a contact cleaner or some other liquid used by household ultrasonic cleaner. On most devices, we proceed with the manual cleaning, part by part. We use a piece of cotton with the help of the precision tweezers to remove the sulfate. We don't have to be in a hurry because little by little we need to clean the whole motherboard. Now the motherboard is looking like this. In the description of this video, you'll find the links from most of the tools that we are using in our workshop. If you like this type of content on our YouTube channel, I'll be grateful if you'll give it a strong like and share it. Thank you. Another fundamental step in our repairs process is to measure the components, looking for a short circuit. At the moment, everything seems fine. With the tip of a scalpel, we scrape the pins. We continue the cleaning process and, in this way, with a lot of patience, we remove all the oxide from the motherboard. Let's check if we have the voltage of the charger. For the moment, everything is perfect. We have the 5-volt input. We try to inspect all the areas from the motherboard, looking for water damages. We use a cordless electric drill to cut this metal sheet, looking for some short circuits and corrosion. For a precision cut, I'll use this flexible cable that comes with the tool. We make small cuts for all the shield corners. Then, with the help of a cutting pliers, we remove the shield. We start cutting the sheet metal, first in a corner and then, little by little, we remove it entirely.
Thank you.
Now, yes, we can inspect the motherboard well and check the main lines. We assemble the device and we press the power button. Guys, he was Leonardo and this was today's video. We hope you like it. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.